I think what we can do now, take advantage that we are still all together, is to get your verbal feedback, because we have the opportunity to listen to everybody's comments, not only in terms as teams, but also individual. So I'd like to start asking one member of each team, could be the PI or somebody else, to share with all of us your experience from the first day of the seminar, which was back in Puerto Plata, you know, the work that you've done virtually over the past 10 months, and that we finished today here in Banff. So if you can share with us a little bit about, you know, the experiences, the processes, the goods and bads, you know, how you have overcome things like that, from the team to the proposal development, but also in terms of perspectives for the future. That we hope that you will continue working together, could be in this project idea, or it could be in some other activities. Sometimes, you know, you're not gonna work in members, a group of eight, but there will be other collaborations going. What other opportunities have, you know, started here, institutional, personal, professional? So please share them. Maybe, you know, there are people that have, just by the fact of meeting other people here, come up with other ideas, and it would be nice for us to know that as well. And after we listen to the PIs or one member of each team, I'd like to ask each of you individually to share your personal, you know, experience participating in the seminar. What are the most important take-home messages that you take to your institution or to the work that you're doing now or to the studies that you're developing now, okay? So who would like to start? We start with the teams.
Okay, so I'll try to wake you up. So how many of you, raise your hand if you know who Michael Jordan is? Okay, so most of you know who Michael Jordan is. In case you don't know, he was a professional basketball player, actually one of the best of the world history of basketball. And as Ramona, I love basketball. The problem is that when Michael Jordan was playing, I liked the team that was always playing the finals with Michael Jordan. That was the Utah Jazz. It was not the the Chicago Bulls. And in Utah Jazz, they had not one figure but two that were Stockton and Malone. They were excellent players. And I liked them better because they were playing more as a team. So Malone was making the points, Stockton was making the assists, and if they were not making the points, there was always Hornacek that was always making great shots. So why I'm saying all this, that it doesn't seem like going anywhere, it's because basketball is a group team. It's a game that you play well if you're in a team, although Michael Jordan was an individual that was outstanding. And basketball has this, you can set a whole list of values that are come with basketball, and I think that that makes a team, and that's one of the main things that, at least for me, I'm taking back home. So you have from respect to each other, you need to rely on others, on what you do. You need leadership. You need to be connected and understand each other and what you're going to do. And all those things and many more values that you can add to that are what makes a team successful. So I made a small round of questions to inside our team to know what we were taking back home. So try to connect the dots from Puerto Plata back here. And many of the things that came are related to those values. So to be flexible when we are trying to communicate with each other and try to build work, to try to really understand each other, have a common language and understand each other and what we are saying when we say something. But most important of all is to have a common objective. So if we know where we want to go, then we are all committed. And that's one of the things that kept our team together in this whole process, because in the beginning we were really excited about this idea, about being together, about building a project, and there was apparently $100,000. But then suddenly we realized that there was no money. So we were like, okay, so what do we do now? We are all very nice people. We all like each other. But if there's nothing we can do with it, where do we go? How we structure the project? What do we do? So, but I think that common objective of that we got during the process, we got convinced. Somebody told me that in our team that step by step, they were getting more faith in the idea. They got more convinced about the objective of conserving the grasslands. And so you have to really believe on something to be committed. And that's another take home message that we get, that if we're really convinced on where we want to go, that's something that holds the team together and makes that people gives feedback and works on a proposal. So, trying to connect the dots. Those values for me are important. Then to have this objective and common language, and trying to connect the dots. On the first day, if you remember, we were presenting posters, and at least for me, one of the most beautiful posters was what Caitlin presented, and she had the Rocky Mountains, and we are ending back in the Rocky Mountains, so that's connecting the dots. And Michael Jordan's last tournament that he won, he didn't make the shot. He made a pass, and it was Steve Kerr who made. So he relied on someone else, was not the big star who made the last shot of his last title. So I think that's something also that makes the team greater and to be connected and makes team successful. So, yeah. I don't know if someone from the groups wants to add something. Yeah, well, thank you.
Bueno, bien, de Puerto Plata para acá, arrancamos con la expectativa que un equipo como el nuestro transdisciplinario podía llegar a alcanzar soluciones mucho más útiles para la sociedad que uno que no lo fuera. Esa es la expectativa. En el camino de hace un año para acá, es darnos cuenta pues, la complejidad que tiene el hacerlo, por las asimetrías de trabajo que existen entre los grupos, es decir, las diferencias de acceso a la información, de trabajo, de perspectivas, etcétera. Eso primero, o sea, un takeaway o algo que puedo, desde mi perspectiva personal, desde mi perspectiva llevar a la casa, es que hay que tener en cuenta pues, esas asimetrías para poder gestionarlas y llevarlas a un producto final, como algo muy importante, y en esta experiencia en Canadá, cómo, y sobre todo con las charlas que tuvimos con los locales, qué tan importante es el entendimiento cultural y el entendimiento intercultural, porque de ahí parte para que yo pueda sacarlo mejor, aprovechar como equipo los inputs que me puedan entregar quienes están participando de él. En nuestra experiencia como equipo la tuvimos, y eso fue algo que hoy reflexionando sobre el trabajo nos dimos cuenta que pertenecía a nuestro grupo, y no solo porque si ponemos el ejemplo caso Cuba, que tiene un acceso a la información mucho más limitado que el nuestro, es exactamente lo que nos va a pasar en una comunidad en un país en teoría que está cubierto de las comunicaciones como Colombia. La comunidad no tiene el mismo acceso que nosotros como equipo vamos a tener. Entonces es como un ejemplo de darse que nos refleja la realidad, y es que tenemos que contextualizar para potencializar lo que cada miembro puede aportar en un proyecto transdisciplinario. Bien, pues digamos que eso es, aparte de las experiencias que tuvimos, sobre todo la gestión, como equipo, que es un desafío al iniciar un proyecto de estos, fundamental, desde mi perspectiva que hago gestión casi que únicamente, soy más generalista que especialista, pues me aporta mucho esto de mirar, pararme en el lugar del otro para ver la perspectiva que tiene y poder entenderla. Eso es un takeaway, algo muy importante para mí. Y bueno, pues como equipo, no sé si quieren agregar algo más. Pero bueno, eso era.
Hey, thank you. It's not. Can you hear me? Yeah. No. Okay. Okay. Well, we write some lines and about that. Well, from Puerto Plata to Calgary, we think that more than a connection, we think that we have an evolution. We think that we have created a process. We begin connecting disciplines, but now we think that we are connecting more than disciplines. We are connecting feelings and different ways to understand the world. We were in two different contexts, with different actors, with different ecosystems, but with similar issues and challenge. And definitely we think that we are more connected than before. We think that when we include difference, we can create a more inclusive world. It's a big challenge. We think as well that definitely there was a big evolution with Puerto Plata and Calgary, and sure that we will continue in this evolution. It's not just about to change a vision of the world for other vision of the world. I think that it's more about a vision of the world that coexists with other visions of the world, where trust and respect can be possible. This is another big challenge. And from a personal point of view, I think that I have been working with some sort of environmental conflicts in rural areas in Colombia. And from my experience, I am more convinced than before that transdisciplinarity is necessary to have a science with more political incidents. And I finished with a sentence of Comandante Marcos from Mexico. It's about un mundo donde quepan otros mundos. I think this is a good sentence to resume that. I don't know if
Bueno, hemos acordado hablar los tres un poco de diferentes temas, y uno de los temas que hemos visto desde Puerto Plata acá es en realidad lo difícil que es ponerse de acuerdo en definir un tema. Y en el proceso que hemos seguido, en realidad lo que vemos es que antes también ya lo había dicho, es partir de explicitar, de que sean muy claros los intereses de todas las partes, ¿no? Intereses profesionales, intereses personales, porque cuando estamos hablando de un proyecto, de una actividad transdisciplinar, no estamos, yo lo veo más como, no es solamente la disciplina, es integrar ideas, intereses de personas, las disciplinas, son instrumentos y nada más, ¿no? Al final de cuentas. Pero entonces en ese proceso hemos tenido como todo proceso, digamos, altibajos. En un principio estábamos muy, aparentemente muy claros y convencidos de qué era el tema, pero luego cuando va pasando el tiempo sobre todo y cada uno se abstrae de ese momento del seminario y entra en la vida nomás, en la rutina o en el conjunto de actividades en las que está cada uno, ahí parece que se va enfriando la cosa, ¿no? Y realmente ahí pesa mucho el tema del liderazgo y de bueno, que se vaya moviendo y motivando la cosa, ¿no? Y entonces hemos tenido varios altibajos, algunas caídas muy duras en el proceso, pero creo que al final hemos llegado, somos menos personas que hemos quedado en el equipo, pero creo que hemos definido un tema muy interesante que tiene un futuro, que tiene una perspectiva interesante de desarrollarse, ¿no? Y sobre todo en este vínculo de la investigación con las políticas, ¿no? Básicamente el corazón de nuestro tema, esto de coping, quedaba un poco, ha quedado en realidad como que a un lado, y tal vez hay algunos temas que, o algunos vínculos con esto del coping, pero en realidad el tema central en el que nos estamos enfocando ahora es el tema de la gobernanza y temas de estrategias de sustento alrededor de la gestión de recursos naturales, ¿no? Y lo que queremos es comparar dos casos que son aparentemente no tienen ninguna relación, pero en realidad sí, hemos ido discutiendo poco a poco qué implicancias tiene cada uno de los casos y cómo vemos este tema. En realidad están muy conectados, ¿no? Por todos los procesos que están en medio, ¿no? Entonces, todo ese proceso yo creo que ha sido muy, muy interesante para nosotros. Otro tema que también aparece en estos procesos es el tema de la incertidumbre, ¿no? Un poco lo que comentaba Pablo, de parte de esas subidas y bajadas ha sido también la la incertidumbre con el tema del si hay o no hay financiamiento, o esto es simplemente el ejercicio como lo que era, digamos, lo que estaba previsto en este evento, que es este seminario de desarrollo profesional. Entendemos que entonces sí hay una oportunidad para motivar, para incentivar, desarrollar una propuesta terminada. Pero bueno, ahí está el tema de la incertidumbre que ha afectado un poco en cierto momento en el desarrollo mismo de la propuesta, ¿no? Eso es básicamente, no sé si…
¿Algún otro comentario de los equipos? I think they were very, very useful, at least for me or for the committee, to listen to your feedback in terms of, you know, the experience as the team, or from building the teams, getting to know each other, picking a common topic of interest, and moving forward, how do we address this as team or as individual members that bring different knowledges and expertise from different countries. So I hope it was a very good exercise. I hope you can build other teams based on this first experience. To some of you, maybe it's not the first experience, to others. But I think the idea is exactly going through this exercise. One thing that I heard from a previous seminar from the participants is that you learn by doing, especially interdisciplinarity and transdisciplinarity, and engaging with social actors. I asked some of them, you know, would you do that again? You know, and most of them said yes. I think it's not for everybody, transdisciplinary research, so you have to come to the conclusion, is this for me or not? But then again, there are the difficulties and there are the rewards. We work with global change problems, and we are very aware they cannot be tackled only by a single discipline, or cannot be tackled properly if you don't involve the policy decision makers, the communities, the ones that are impacted by those changes or those problems. But there are many challenges. I think you face some of them by doing, and I think hopefully these have some lessons learned, and we hope you can continue, you know, in pursuing this kind of research and this kind of collaboration. Now, before we go into individual testimonies, or that you can share with us your individual experience, I'd like to ask Jessica. She wants to share with us a proposal for something she wants to do with the group. So, Jessica, please.
Thank you. Just to follow your reflections and what have been learning during this year of working in transdisciplinary research, you also can think about that this is a knowledge that we have, a knowledge that is our responsibility to distribute or to communicate to the public. So one way to communicate what we have been learning, one way to construct the knowledge, synthesize our experience, is to write notes, essays, articles. There are many kind of forms that we can synthesize the information, and I would like to invite you to do so and to build together a special issue in the Vínculos magazine, Vínculos is a journal that is hosted by my university, Universidad de las Fuerzas Armadas de Spain, Ecuador. And this is a journal that the focus is to communicate the links between the academia and the society in all of the forms. It's an academic journal. It has the academic accreditations. You will have the DOI, and we have an open source platform. So the work will be visible online. It's a peer review, but also has some editorial changes that is not a traditional journal. So we have pictures, we have not only research articles, but notes, essays, any type of contributions, because as you can see, transdisciplinary research also needs transformation in the way that the information is communicated for all of the audience. And if you were in the academia, you see that the journals, the academic journals, are mostly of them are monodisciplinary, and with that restriction, you can miss to communicate the essence of transdisciplinary research. So hopefully I can translate this will be a space to disseminate the knowledge that we have been gaining and construction here in these different topics: transdisciplinary teamwork and process, transdisciplinary proposal development and project management, methods, science policy interface, transdisciplinary research and science diplomacy, science communication, successful projects, current projects, emerging ideas, and other field of driving programs. And diverse contributions from all backgrounds are welcome. So Mariana will be in touch with all of us, and she will distribute the call, and also she will be helping receiving the articles. And the committee, the organization committee, will be the editorial scientific committee of this special issue. So who would like to contribute first? I brought some chocolates. Who wants the first chocolate?
Yeah.
So the question is how long needs to be. So as I said, there is no restriction. It's as flexible as we need. The journal has the flexibility that we need to communicate transdisciplinary research. So no worries about that.
Deadline.
Good question. Yeah, we put November 11 as a deadline. And why?
For the article.
Why? Why? Because
1 month.
Yes, we have 1 month. Because I have the budget to do the printed version, so I can print 500 issues and send the issues, the printed version, to you. But I have to do it by December or January next year. So we need. We have a short deadline, but I think we are ready. As Pablo already has a topic, right?
The end of November?
Okay.
Okay.
Second call, the first call, November 11, will be a second call, but you know. So. I will suggest if you write in English, do the summary in Spanish, and if you write in Spanish, do the abstract in English. Mm-hmm. Yep. Yeah. So. So have the chocolates. I brought chocolates from Ecuador. Take as many as you want.
So we're going to start with the individual experiences.
Can you start with someone else? Because I have to think.
Who wants to start? Like, who wants? Ideally, if we could go.
Just
like
out, please. Yes. Go away. Person.
Start there by Margan.
Okay. Oh, chocolate's here. Pressure's on. Thank you for all your hard work. You've been amazing, and you've done so much progress. So really thank you, and congratulations. So please. To all the participants, but also thank you to the IAI, Marcela and Mariana, of course, for bringing us here, the steering committee, and very, very specially, Gabby, because she brought us to Banff, which is one of the most beautiful places in the world. And not only that, she brought us to the people that the First Nations. This is an extraordinary experience that nobody can have. And really, I want to emphasize what a big deal and how privileged we are to have met with these people and went to their sites. So really, thank you. Gracias, Gabby. We really, 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 really appreciate what you did for us.
I'm not good in talk in front of all of you, especially in another language, so I'll be very fast. I was thinking about one word that can summarize all the learnings. Gabby, you are crying, I can't look to you. all right, so. For me, the word is respect. Respect for a difference, different cultures, different backgrounds, different.
Pressure.
Yeah, pressure. And respect for what is different, different of us, different of me. And I have learned a lot. During this process with my group, with all of you guys. You are very funny. Yes, I was telling to my husband about all of you today. Yes, it was really good. And that's it. I hope to see all of you in Brazil someday or in some place around the world. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, girls.
Bueno, por mi parte quería agradecerles a los organizadores todo el esfuerzo que han puesto en la organización de estos dos seminarios. No, imagino que no es sencillo desde el punto de vista logístico, así que y todo ha salido muy bien. La verdad que yo particularmente me he sentido muy cómoda, así que muchas gracias por todo eso. En relación a mi experiencia personal, me quedo con varios aprendizajes. En primer lugar, que el campo transdisciplinario es un campo en construcción, que no hay recetas para hacer esto. Por lo tanto, me parece que todos estamos convocados a aportar desde el punto de vista conceptual y metodológico en este campo en construcción. Por otro lado, la necesidad de trabajar con otros actores externos al campo académico en el abordaje y el estudio y la intervención de los problemas del cambio global, en el sentido de no integrarlos desde un punto de vista subordinado, sino incluirlos en pie de igualdad, asumiendo que la ciencia es una parte importante y relevante para el estudio de los problemas del cambio global, pero no es suficiente, ¿no? Que tiene sus limitaciones, que deberemos asumir y explicitar. Por otro lado, también me parece que el campo transdisciplinario está llamado a adoptar una posición política, ¿no? Me parece que podemos contribuir todos a realizar una ciencia política, una ciencia comprometida, una ciencia heterodoxa, que no solamente se limita a la descripción de los problemas del cambio global, sino que también contribuya a preparar a las instituciones y a las comunidades para poder afrontar la gestión de estas problemáticas, ¿no? Eso me parece que es muy relevante y que todos podemos aportar en ese sentido. Así que les agradezco a todos por la experiencia y bueno, esperemos seguir en contacto.
Well, for me, I think two main messages. One is to always be open to perceive and absorb different worldviews, and also the importance to build relationships and really connect with each other and with the people that we are willing to work with. And one thing that I really am taking back home, but as a challenge, is because it's easier to remind of all of that here, because we are immersed and always talking about how to do and what not to do. But when we are back home in our daily lives in a hurry, and sometimes it's difficult to remember all of that. So that's something that I'm keeping remembered, not to lose all of that learning while I'm back home. And thank you all for the wonderful program, and especially for the experience that we had tomorrow and today. And really, thank you.
Bueno, también lo formal, pero no es tan formal, también tiene que ver con una cosa de más emocional. Agradecerles a la organización todo el empeño, el soportarnos. Sí, así que creo que ha sido una muy buena experiencia. La verdad que yo aposté por intentar aplicar a este seminario sin saber lo que me iba a encontrar. Me parecía interesante que hubiera una propuesta de juntar distintas perspectivas. Entonces, desde ese punto de vista me interesó. Pero me sorprendió la capacidad humana. Es decir, si bien es cierto, con todo, yo, por ejemplo, no con todo he podido conversar profundamente, siento que hay una impronta verdadera detrás, ¿eh? Que en definitiva aquí estamos conversando entre pares, ¿ya? Y que en definitiva lo importante ahí es rescatar ese aspecto de reciprocidad. Y yo lo he vivido en el grupo, por ejemplo, que estamos más en contacto de manera más cotidiana, que el trabajar, las apuestas éticas que hacemos del trabajo en el campo, tienen que ver con este mismo ejercicio de reciprocidad, es decir, yo hago por ti y tú haces por mí, y sin un interés detrás, sino que por hacer cambios. Y como decía Erika, esto del método, la forma de esta disciplina que está en construcción, yo creo que desde ahí es una suerte de apostar por un cambio, de cómo se debieran hacer las cosas desde esta perspectiva, que lo implica mucho, lo dijo Alex, de una manera inclusiva, con no los objetos de la ciencia, sino que los sujetos, que es la comunidad. Así que les agradezco la oportunidad, ha sido muy interesante, y probablemente, como es una red, nos vamos a volver a ver en algún momento, en alguna parte, probablemente diferente a esta. Chile tiene lugares muy bonitos también. Así que muchas gracias por todo.
Only sad that I didn't get to join your group earlier, but I'm glad that I've gotten to know you all, and you're a very welcoming group, so I already feel like I'm part of the group. And I just want to point out that probably for everybody, since you are used to working in other countries or across languages, that it seems like a normal thing. But I think we're all very unique in that the majority of the world doesn't do that, and most people don't feel comfortable not only trying new food or cultures, but traveling and trying to bridge these gaps that everyone keeps talking about. So just keep in mind that that's a very unique skill we all have, and it's a really good thing to develop as we keep working together to solve problems.
Let's finish in the back. Sorry.
De pronto dicen algo de lo que ya dije en inglés. Pues muchas gracias, agradecimiento a los organizadores. Realmente sé que organizar esto no es fácil, y a veces es más todo el trabajo que está de fondo que lo que realmente uno ve. Uno todo lo ve muy fácil. Y sí, se reconoce pues todo el esfuerzo que hubo previo. Entonces, agradecer todo eso infinitamente porque, pues sí, creo que el espacio se dio y funcionó muy bien, todo perfecto, el espacio, el lugar. Y yo sí siento que se evolucionó mucho, es decir, desde la primera conferencia a Puerto Plata, sí sentí, para mí la palabra, si quisiera resumir algo, sería eso, como evolución y creación de procesos, ¿no? Que realmente no es un producto que termina, sino que sigue, ¿sí? Que finalmente es también la vida, ¿no? Un poco. Y a mí me gusta pues esa idea, por ejemplo, en el caso de, ya personal, en mi trabajo, que hemos tratado de incluir estas visiones diferentes. Estas son unas buenas herramientas para hacerlo en contextos complejos, ¿no? Yo personalmente trabajo en contextos complejos de conflicto y no hay otra. Es decir, ahí sí no hay una forma de escoger. ¿Es esto o es esto? O sea, no podemos construir si no lo hacemos así. No sé si de otras disciplinas que otros trabajan, pero en mi caso estudio, me doy cuenta que no hay otra posibilidad. Entonces, ya es una apuesta que uno hace. Entonces, el aporte que ha tenido para mí es inmenso porque me llevo que eso que uno pensaba a nivel local o a nivel nacional es posible y es una cuestión que se comparte con otras personas que están en la misma temática. Y eso te ayuda como a sentirte mejor, acompañado, de pronto que se puede, ¿no? Yo creo que ese es el reto, ¿no? Decir, bueno, ya no es un poco de soñar, porque alguien dice, ah, esto es iluso pensar que usted puede realmente incluir e incidir en cambios locales. Ya es una posibilidad que uno comparte, porque creo que esta temática trasciende fronteras, ¿no? Entonces, gracias por ese espacio. Fue un gran proceso de aprendizaje para mí que de seguro va a continuar. Gracias.
I'll start by thanking the organizers as well, the steering committee, and especially Gabby. Because we're in the same city, I got to see Gabby sometimes. And so I know how much effort this was, and especially the field trip yesterday and engaging with the indigenous communities. That, Marga, you're right, like that's really unique. These are places that I, maybe on some level I knew they existed, but I had never seen them either, and I live really close. So yeah, really special opportunity. I when I think back to where I was in my professional and personal development a year ago, like right before Puerto Plata, like there's no comparison to where I am now. And I'm so inspired and like I talk so much about IAI and this group and so much. I know you, Marcella, you said we should talk about what else we've done. Like it's crazy how like I feel like I've really tried to leverage things. So I was really inspired after Puerto Plata. I wanted to do a master's and something connected to communicating science and this idea. So my program is Science in a Changing World. I'm sure I got in in large part thanks to my recommendation letters from Pablo and from Gabby. So I had them write my reference letters, and now I'm in this master's program, which will hopefully open up more doors and create more opportunity. And I want to focus a lot of my stuff on sustainability. I keep bringing in examples into my coursework from this. Also, I participated in the science diplomacy, the AAAS, that Marga organized, and Marcella recommended me and wrote a really, really lovely letter so that I could go. And Jesse was there as well, and so more connection. Like, it's so exciting to see. There was a paper that a girl in Virginia and I worked on, and so we published, and like, I wouldn't have even met you, much less think, you know, that I could be part of something like that, working towards, it was focused on food loss and food waste, so and part of SDGs, which is what I was talking about earlier this week. So yeah, incredible, like this is amazing. And I know Gabby, you said that yourself about your own experience with IAI, that this has really like shifted your whole direction career-wise, of like that IAI has really made this great opportunity. And like, I have no idea where I'm going, really, career-wise. Maybe some of you feel similarly. Yeah, I'm not sure where I'm going to go or what I'm going to do, but this has really, really transformed
my view and where I see myself going. And that's so exciting, and I'm so, so grateful. So, and all of you have been a part of that journey as well, and I'm so grateful. So thank you.
Well, I really appreciate the chance to be with all of you again. My professional life changed a lot from Puerto Plata to now, because I returned to the Ministry of Environment in Brazil in a moment that the environmental agenda in Brazil is being attacked so hard, so strong. And a lot of things that we're facing there's a lot of interests going on in the country right now, but there's also the lack of knowledge of how to approach a lot of the problems that we deal, not only in Brazil, but in other countries as well. And a lot of the solutions that we could arise to tackle this situation could come from groups like this. So working for the government, it's really easy to forget how connected we are with these issues. And I'm really glad to have the chance to be here again and have a chance to take a break from the issues that you have every day in the government and be with you, exchange this knowledge, to have the chance to take that back and try to implement, try to foresee solutions for the things that you're facing. Of course, that is not going, we cannot put all the charge on science to make the solution. A lot of this situation came from political issues. But even though it's important to have like the trade-off analysis to politicians to understand what's going on. So for me, it's a great opportunity to get back to see you all again. I hope that you can still have these opportunities to bring these solutions, these proposals to the government and to other stakeholders so we can move forward on this agenda. So thank you, all of you, and especially for the organizers for the chance to be here again.
I wrote on some stuff. this seminar has been very eye-opening. One of the things I wrote down that I really got from the seminar was how we should break down the barriers between disciplines and include both local and indigenous knowledge to achieve a solution and to engender change and influence policy. That's one of the main takeaways. And in doing this, sometimes we need to have conversations which may be uncomfortable, but are important to have. Today, for example, the session today was really resonated with me. What Ramona and Duane were mentioning. And it opened my eyes to see that the struggles that First Nations went through, and even the documentary that Jorge showed, that we have shared struggles, shared pain, and I think we should be open to acknowledging that and respecting that, right? And I'm very happy that I organized this seminar, because honestly, I don't think I would have been aware, you know, of the of this type of conversation, right? I'm very happy for that. I'm very happy to be a part of a group of diverse persons, personalities that are just very inspiring, right? I'm from a very small island, and sometimes you seemed kind of locked away, but I'm happy to be here to kind of open up, broaden my horizon to see what's out there, right? First time seeing snow, so that's good. First time seeing a prairie, so that's good as well. So I'm just very happy to share this experience.
For me, it was also a very, very, very valuable experience. I should thank you all, the organizers, and particularly to Carol, that really insisted on me for applying for this seminar the last year. Yeah, because as soon as I get the invitation, I understand what you say. I couldn't understand what would be my role in these kind of seminars. What's, I don't know, I couldn't understand even what the title was about. So not even thinking on applying for these kind of seminars, but I would say I do it because of Carol, because I wouldn't like to disappoint her, so I, but really expecting not to be selected, you know? And it was a terrible period for me, because it was my child's birthday, so I was not expecting to be in Puerto Plata for sure. And then I got the invitation. So, and back in Puerto Plata, I learned about this token word that I never heard before. And I should say that after this really good year experience, I never felt like that. Because as soon as I learned that that word, I say, okay, that's my role here. I'm going to be the token in my group and in this whole seminar, coming from the private sector, you know? And I never felt like that, so thanks to my group, thanks to all of you. And I learned a lot. I would say my main takeaway is each one of you, meeting new people. You know, I teach theory of knowledge in high school as a hobby, I should say, because it's not related to my professional field. So some people run, some people dance. I teach theory of knowledge. Yeah, sí, aburridísima, una vida aburrida. So okay, no, but I never connected. Though theory of knowledge is, for those that doesn't know, is about different ways of knowing, different areas of knowledge, and how they really interact, and how they shape the way we think and shape the way we see the world. So of course it should be totally connected to my work, but I would never connect those dots if without this seminar, without the experience of this seminar. So thank you very much for that also at a professional level. And finally, to continue with my boss analogy, Pablo is our boss, you know? The analogy with the sports, but not basketball. Even though Argentina is out of the, I would say almost out of the World Cup, I will talk about football. I don't care. So this is a very short story about football, and these two guys having to choose their teams for a football match, and so they throw the coin. So who is the first that is starting choosing the players for his team? So the one that get the first chance to select his team, he start choosing the you Pablo, then I don't know, a lot of women decide. So he start choosing the best players for his team, and the other, let's call it Juan, he start choosing. His most dearest and closest persons to be selected. So when they up each one with his team with their teams, the one that choose the best players asked Juan, "Why didn't you choose, at least some of the best players? Because you have one chance, then you have the chance to and you keep choosing these lousy players, and I kept the best players in my team." And so Juan asking, okay, because in the chance we win, if our team win, that's always good, Everybody likes to win and to celebrate, and it doesn't matter who is in the team, because for celebration it's easy. Everybody is up to celebration. But in the case we lose, that is always the case. You have always the chance to lose. I know that my team will be the best team to lose together, and still play again and keep playing. So I think that our team in Grasslands particularly, and this whole team, I think we have built this kind of team that is ideally for winning or for losing. So we will keep together, I'm sure of that. Thank you.
Bien, por supuesto, sumarme a los agradecimientos de todos. Y me gusta la frase que muchos utilizan de como ciudadano del mundo, ¿no? quisiera agradecer que a agentes de cambio que somos, ustedes los unen para que realicen un cambio sustancial y con contenido. Y eso es algo extremadamente valioso desde mi perspectiva profesional, el hacer parte de eso, porque de hecho estamos, tenemos una responsabilidad generacional, los que estamos sentados acá, porque estamos por algo que hemos hecho antes, de generar soluciones y juntar más de 30, 40 personas para hacerlo, es como dicen, quitarse el sombrero y agradecerlo de una manera fuerte. Desde la personal, lo más importante para mí, me sumo a algunos comentarios, es que tengo ya casi 40 personas a las que con muchísimo gusto y quisiera volver a ver, y estarían o están muy conectados ahora. Tengo 40 amigos más, podríamos decir, en idioma latinoamericano, ¿no? Y eso es lo más valioso para mí. O sea, que tengo, y sobre todo la calidad de personas que tengo alrededor. Entonces, por eso, pues muchas gracias. Ya el resto, creo que lo han dicho mis colegas y solo quería sumarlo.
I want to thank. I want to thank the organizers as well. Like, everybody's done that already, but I want to do it again. This experience has been amazing, and especially I agree. Today and yesterday for me it was very powerful and almost magical. Like, I felt really connected with the activities that we did, it resonated to me when they mentioned about, you know, you don't have to really be talking about too many things. You just have to be there and kind of like feel it. And I kind of like felt it when I was there. And I think that in general, the whole seminar has been like that. Just like being with you guys and connecting with you guys and like being in our group and like learning from you guys. Like, it's been really great. I agree with Jorge that when I applied initially, I was just, you know, this seems interesting. Okay, I'll just apply. You know, like not really having any clear expectation. And what has been really unique is the fact that we saw each other once, and then we had this full year to kind of like develop ourselves in our own unique way and see ourselves like again a second time. I think that has been really, really great. For me, I have already been like developing some types of, you know, transdisciplinary approaches in my work back home. And so coming here and learning from what all of you guys are doing, that just like, even though it's completely maybe different things, I just like see something, I'm like, oh, I could apply this. So I'm always kind of like on the lookout for that and learning about new things. So I'm a marine person, right? So like grasslands, like who knew? So like for me, it's like an important thing. Like all those kind of things like really open up a lot of perspectives. So yeah, just thank you once again, and thank you to all of you, because you're amazing, and you're all invited to come and swim with manta rays in Peru. So just come over.
Bueno, igual me sumo mucho a las palabras que ya todos dijeron. Agradecer al gran equipo de organizadores. Agradecer también la humildad con que cada uno enfrenta a los otros y conversa sin digamos prejuicios ni nada. Y nada, recordar que yo ingresé a estudiar ingeniería en recursos naturales por azar, digamos. Me tincó mucho porque después de leer un libro argentino de Sábato y la resistencia, y hoy día vi resistencia, o sea, este seminario fue resistencia, lo vi en el campo, vi la memoria como lucha para seguir viva. Y nada, agradecerles a cada uno de ustedes. Espero nos veamos pronto.
Bueno, sobre la parte del seminario, creo que antes hablé, digamos, el proceso que hemos seguido como grupo, pero también personalmente. Bueno, creo que además de agradecer por ese proceso, por el objetivo mismo del taller, quiero agradecerles por esta oportunidad de tener esta otra vivencia. A mí me gustan mucho las montañas, yo vengo de también de un país de montañas, ¿no? Y me ha impactado bastante el viaje de ayer y hablar con la gente y estar ahí, simplemente estar presente en esos lugares. En realidad me ha servido para recordar de que somos parte de este paisaje. Me ha gustado mucho el concepto que maneja la gente acá, como somos el paisaje, somos parte del paisaje, de un territorio. Y pensando en el tema del seminario, en realidad creo que muchas veces nos olvidamos de eso, ¿no? Y estamos demasiado concentrados en nuestros objetos de estudio o de trabajo y no estamos viendo la totalidad, ¿no? Y para mí ha sido muy valioso, muy, muy conmovedor, muy fuerte eso que hemos visto en estos dos días, ¿no? Cómo la gente ve esos temas, ve la integralidad de una persona, de un ser, no solamente en la cabeza, y lo ha explicitado muy bien, lo han explicitado los dos esta mañana. Entonces, por una parte la integralidad de la persona, del ser humano, pero por otra parte la integralidad de la naturaleza, el paisaje, el territorio, ¿no? Y entonces son muy mensajes muy fuertes para que creo que tenemos que irlos recordando cada que podamos, o tenemos que ser cada vez más conscientes de eso, ¿no? De que estamos inmersos en una vida un poco ajetreada y nos olvidamos realmente de eso, ¿no? Entonces, gracias por esa oportunidad.
Bueno, yo soy una persona de poco hablar. No me creen, pero es así. Nada, pero me veo obligado a hablar. Y primero, voy a comenzar por la tarde. Cuando terminamos el almuerzo, cuando íbamos a almorzar, vimos un reno. Y fuimos rápido a tirar fotos. Y todos preocupados. ¡Alex! Te puede hacer daño. ¿Qué significa eso? Que estamos en una familia. Que hay sentido de familia, de compañerismo, que hemos establecido lazos de amistad, de cariño. Y yo pienso que eso siempre será lo más importante. Porque por ahí comienza también la ética, el amor por el prójimo, por el igual, y estamos en condiciones de hacer mejor nuestro trabajo. La inmensa mayoría de nosotros somos servidores públicos. Y recuerdo que el año pasado, el Papa Francisco en Cuba, ya lo había dicho anteriormente, dijo que quien no vive para servir, no sirve para vivir. Ayer lo comentábamos Alejandro y Vicky en una conversación. Y pienso que lo más importante es que con este seminario, primero en Dominicana y ahora aquí en Canadá, hemos podido ganar un grupo de herramientas, crear un grupo de vínculos, organizar el trabajo en los grupos, tener ya propuestas. Y mirando las propuestas de cada uno de nosotros, me doy cuenta que en la mayoría van dirigidas a hacerle mejor la vida a la gente, a nuestra familia, a los vecinos, a personas que no conocemos, pero que también hacen mejor la vida nuestra. Y yo pienso que ya con eso hemos ganado mucho. Y bueno, para terminar, quiero agradecer mucho al IAI por el apoyo, especialmente a las personas de Cuba, de participar en este seminario. A Marga, también a Marcela por la inmensa cantidad de correos que hemos compartido. Pero sobre todo quiero agradecer especialmente a una persona que me parece que ha hecho posible que todos estemos aquí, que es Mariana Toledo. Muy trabajadora. Muy trabajadora, muy atenta. Correos a toda hora y todos los días. Y nada, pienso que es una persona que es muy buena en el team de todo el mundo. Ella es el team de todos. Nada, las gracias a usted y espero que nos veamos pronto y que todo nos siga saliendo bien. Y todos están invitados a Cuba.
Sí. Bueno, creo que no está de más y no nos vamos a cansar de agradecerles a todos los organizadores y a todas las personas que hicieron posible que estemos acá nuevamente en este taller. Así que gracias nuevamente a todos, ¿verdad? Porque realmente si organizar un almuerzo cuesta una en mi país, no puedo imaginarme el nivel de esto, ¿verdad? Así que muchas gracias por el tiempo que le han invertido, porque realmente ha sido un éxito tanto la de Puerto Plata como la de acá. De las cosas que me llevo, creo que voy a decir una palabra y es comunicación. La comunicación efectiva creo que es muy importante a todos los niveles, ¿verdad? Acá lo vimos a nivel de comunidades indígenas, yo lo vivo en mi país también, con comunidades indígenas, con comunidades rurales. Entonces creo que la comunicación efectiva, y cuando digo efectiva me refiero a que es saber hablar, saber comunicarse, y no solo eso, sino también saber escuchar, ¿verdad? Para conocer tanto las limitaciones como las fortalezas de las personas, porque eso nos ayuda a poder definir roles de una mejor forma, ¿verdad? Tanto dentro de la propuesta como para otras cosas. Casi no vengo al taller por los problemas que tuve con mi pasaporte, y al principio estaba muy, muy preocupada por no poder cumplir con la responsabilidad de venir a la segunda parte del taller. Eso me preocupaba de sobremanera. Pero cuando vine acá el primer día y llegué al salón, estuve comunicándome con Jenny y me dijo, sí, estamos aquí cerca, solo tienes que cruzarte la calle. Así que yo solo tiré mi maleta y salí corriendo para no perderme más. Fue tan gratificante la bienvenida que me dieron todos. Cuando todos, Gaby, viniste, lo lograste. Todos me abrazaron, todos, qué bueno que lo lograste, no importa que te hayas perdido. Lo primero, aquí estás, ya lo lograste. Me sentí tan bien porque parecía como que habíamos sido amigos de toda la vida. No parecía que el tiempo había pasado, no parecían 10 meses que pasamos sin vernos. O sea, fue como que hubiera sido ayer lo de Puerto Plata. Entonces fue muy gratificante, y como dijo aquí Cuba, Alex, hicimos lazos de amistad muy fuertes, y creo que esa es la característica de nuestra región, de Latinoamérica. Somos, yo pensaba que era solo de Latinoamérica, pero acá estamos de todas partes del mundo y no solo somos nosotros, o sea, somos todos, ¿verdad? Entonces, gracias por hacer eso posible, porque nos damos cuenta que tenemos muchas cosas en común, ¿verdad? Que los problemas de mi país no son solo de mi país, sino que son de la región, y no solo incluso de la región, son problemas de todos, ¿verdad? Entonces, creo que esta oportunidad nos ayuda a abrir los ojos y darnos cuenta que se puede hacer algo, ¿verdad? Que podemos hacer muchas cosas para cambiar, y empezando por nosotros mismos, una cosa muy chiquita. Entonces creo que vamos muy bien. Gracias por esta oportunidad nuevamente, porque podemos hacer la diferencia. La estamos haciendo ya. Y creo que el transdisciplinary approach es la única forma que lo podemos hacer, porque es la única forma que podemos abordar la problemática en todos los ángulos, ¿verdad? Todo, ¿verdad? Entonces, muchas gracias, y aquí lo dejo.
Ya tú sabes. No, principalmente y primero agradecer a Lía y Marcela, Mariana. No, o sea, Gaby, yo entiendo de verdad, de todo corazón, el esfuerzo que se realiza. O sea, organizar una actividad internacional, nacional es un problema. Internacional son otros niveles. Entonces, de llevarlo tan perfecto como ustedes lo han hecho, de verdad que no tiene palabra. Y abrácense ustedes mismas, de verdad que sí, porque esto es con lágrimas, de todo lo que ustedes... Sí, lágrimas, sangre, todo lo que ustedes quieran. Eso es lo primero. Lo segundo es, creo que con quien más, dentro de los argumentos y de las felicitaciones, las palabras que dijeron, con Gabriel me doy perfecto, y con Alexander. ¿Por qué? En el 2015, cuando llego de mi maestría, me pasa lo mismo que Gabriel, entro otra vez al gobierno, a mi institución, uno llega con las ganas de Superman, Superwoman, quiero cambiar todo, y te encuentras con muchas barreras, y te encuentras con un montón de cosas que no lo dejaste y creías que ibas a funcionar. Entonces, antes de este seminario, esta iniciativa, yo empiezo en otra red de personas, igual que esta, llamado el PDC. Entonces, mi primera experiencia fue en Indonesia, donde yo veo un grupo increíble de personas en cambio climático, pero no solamente políticos, sino de todas las multidisciplinas y todos los multisectores. Tan pronto yo salgo de ahí, nos piden que busquemos otras personas que les gustaría pertenecer a la red. Primero yo pienso, Carol debe estar aquí porque economía, cambio climático, todo. Entonces, ¿qué pasa? Si hubiera conocido este montón de personas, no, la lista se llena con nosotros, señores, de verdad. Eso es lo primero. Segundo, la primera reunión, segunda reunión después de eso, era en Sudáfrica. Me pasa estilo Gaby, mi visa nunca llegó, no pude ir, mando a Carol sola, me estaba, o sea, la vida me dijo de todo. ¿Cómo tú me mandas esto sola? ¿Qué sé yo qué? Y le digo yo, no te preocupes, te va a gustar. Llega. Le digo yo, ¿llegaste? Sí, bien. Hay una argentina chulísima que te va a encantar y un grupo de latinos que no vas a salir de ellos. Alejandro es uno, Alejandro Carlos Alberto. Virginia y Carol, desde ese día, o sea, más otro grupo de personas, fuimos inseparables. Y desde ese 2015 hasta ahora, seguimos como el primer día. Lo mismo pasó en Punta Cana, en Puerto Plata. El ya tú sabes. ¿Alguien sabe cuál es la expresión ya tú sabes? ¿No? Okay. Somebody knows that expression in English, like, you know, right? Like, you know. Exactly. That's an expression. That's what I thought. It was a simple expression, right? No. Argentina pensó que eso era una cosa del otro mundo. Uruguay también, Chile, o sea, y fue el grupo Ya Tú Sabes. Ya Tú Sabes, che, porque teníamos que darle hashtag Ya Tú Sabes. O sea, búsquenlo en Twitter, Instagram y todo. Entonces, ese nivel de sentimiento de una red de personas, pero no solamente de profesionales, sino de amigos, de familia. Tengo tres hermanas nuevas, las hermanas Venancio, que sale como si nada, o sea, fue una cosa increíble. Y así, con esas palabritas y esas conexiones, o sea, tú conectas con la persona, no solamente a nivel profesional, sino a un nivel personal. Y créanme que esas son las que duran más. Entonces, muchísimas gracias. No digo bye, hasta luego, adiós, no, esto sigue. Créanme, de una forma u otra, aunque uno salga de Canadá, vaya a regreso a casa, tenga unos meses de silencio total, pero créanme que estas redes vuelven, porque es tanto el nivel y la intensidad que tú le des, así mismo se te devuelve. Gracias.
Bueno, voy a ser breve, pero a esta altura me identifico con muchas de las cosas que dijeron. Y quisiera agradecerles, bueno, a todos, a los organizadores, pero a todos, porque, bueno, este proceso lo construimos juntos. Y la verdad que desde el equipo y todo el grupo fue sensacional todo lo que pudimos aprender, ¿no?, entre nosotros. Y pensando, bueno, volviendo al primer día en Puerto Plata, me acuerdo de llegar con una idea de lo que era la transdisciplina, ¿no?, de haber leído los artículos que nos recomendaron, de haber tenido otras experiencias. Y bueno, durante esa semana fui dándome cuenta que era otra cosa, ¿no? Y ese concepto fue evolucionando y sigue evolucionando hasta el día de hoy. Y bueno, me parece que fue muy importante en eso también aprender a través de la experiencia, ¿no? En la práctica fue como que somos parte de este pequeño experimento, ¿no? Pero, o sea, uno puede leer muchas cosas, pero si pierde como este contacto con las personas y, bueno, pensar todos juntos, me parece que bueno, ese proceso de aprendizaje llegó para otro lado, ¿no? Entonces, bueno, me encantó esta experiencia porque justamente, o sea, dio ese plus, ¿no? Y después, bueno, como retos o desafíos a futuro, voy a intentar aplicar todo esto y, bueno, seguir profundizando en nuevos proyectos que empiezo ahora dentro de poquito en Uruguay. Así que, bueno, de repente les escribo para pedir una mano y seguir profundizando. Y bueno, y también invitarlos a todos a Uruguay, no solo a conocer los pastizales, Pablo, porque hay muchas cosas más. Los pastizales sí, pero los podemos llevar a la playa, bueno, a muchos lugares. Así que bueno, son todos bienvenidos, peguen el grito, como dicen allá, por Uruguay cuando vayan.
Sí. Thank you very much for letting me join you all. And thank you to Gabriella, who needs to sleep for 3 weeks now, and Marcella and Mariana, who are need to sleep as well along. And the one thing that I would like to challenge you all to do is to look at your country's call for authors for the upcoming working group report number 6 of the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. You're all now experts in working in interdisciplinary and collaborative teams. I don't know what the deadlines are. The deadline for Canada for self-nomination is today. It's the
20th. October 26th is the deadline to
But each country, like today is Canada's, and so I've had 10 people email me to say they're self-nominating, which is great, and to say, are you? So IPCC is seeking scientists in the hope that more scientists from developing countries and more women scientists will be nominated. They want to have in the next report a balance of men and women, as well as those experienced and those new to the process, including younger scientists. So this is something you should at least all give a little bit of attention to, because you all know what it's like to work in these teams. So good luck with that, and try the unconference. You will give them, I sent all the reports that will come into your inbox. Thank you very much, and safe journey home.
Just very briefly, before I hand in the microphone, I had an interview before to share my thoughts about this, and it occurred to me that a year ago we were in Puerto Plata, and now we are in this beautiful setting, both of them very beautiful but very different. So it occurred to me that that's an example of what we saw here, because we couldn't think of two physical settings more different than what we had, no? A warm beach and a cold mountain, both of them extremely beautiful on their own. And that also is an example of what we have here at the personal level, because we brought people from different disciplines, from different fields, from different types of work that you do, some government, some academia, some private sector. And so I think that shows the diversity that AI is trying to bring together, and the challenge that it is to have those extreme come and define a single goal. And you all have seen that challenge in developing your proposals, how complicated it is to bring people from different mindsets to work on a similar goal. And that is definitely a challenge, but I think that the most important thing that you have all achieved and that you have already indicated here is the friendship and the teams that you have already integrated. And I think that's the most valuable thing, because it's gonna last way beyond the proposal, way beyond the project, and that's gonna allow you not only to grow professionally, but more importantly, to grow as persons. And speaking for myself, I really enjoyed being here and being back a year ago with you all and learning from all of you. That's the most rewarding thing to me, being invited as an instructor to these activities, that more than coming to share something with you, I come and I learn from all of you. And I really valued all the conversations we had and all the things that you shared with me. And I really take that back home. I really hope that you all feel the same way. You have expressed that. That's the most valuable thing we have, the team and the friendship and the family, like Alex was saying, no, that now we are. And that family and that those bonds will last for sure, but we need to cultivate them, no? So make sure that when you go back home, even though we all get very busy, do send an email once in a while, do log in to whatever system we have for communication and stay in touch, no? So Again, great seeing you again, and good luck with all your proposals and also with all your different activities as persons and as scientists. Thank you.
Well, also thank you for organizing this and giving me the opportunity to be here with this great good group of people. I had a similar thing like Virginia when I got this, I received this opportunity and I talked to Valentin. Yeah, he mentioned transdisciplinarity and science policy link and international relations and diplomacy. And I was like, well, this has nothing to do with me. This is some, yeah, it's, where are the cows? Where are the grasslands? I mean, but then getting there in Puerto Plata and looking and knowing you, it was really amazing. I was really amazed of the level of you personally and also professionally. And I was like, wow, these people is really important. It's I got a bit scared, but it's been great. And also trying to link Puerto Plata and Calgary and Banff. I remember that by the end of our experience in Puerto Plata, we had this presentation by Gary when he was remembering all this poverty process in Brazil, and it was quite emotional. And I think this morning we had quite similar. So by the end of the week, we had this really touching experience of in your video. That for me it was a very humbling moment, and it was really, yeah, knowing that we are really fortunate people for the conditions that we have and the quality of life we have, and that there's a lot of people there that it's segregated and oppressed, and yeah, that made me really humble. So that was one of the learning things that I had from this program. And also the other one, it's that I'm not a very spiritual person, so I don't believe that there's a God up there or something. But yesterday when we went up there, the hill, and I felt all that wind, that thing that they were saying that, well, you have to experience that, I felt something. I felt the wind, I felt really these things going away, but also I made friends with wind. So that was, and I cannot really explain it, but it's, yeah, that was also something really, really, yeah, relevant for this experience. So I also learned that, well, Skype meetings of 2 hours are too long, that you have to make it two, one, and that there's something called the Oxford comma. So you can go to Caitlin, she will love it and will explain to you all of it. But no, it's really been great, and yeah, and thank you all, and yeah. Oh, but also, yeah, going back to what you said, this is not over, and I think that we should really think about a platform to be connected, to share our knowledge, but also to be connected socially. We have the Ya Tu Sabes Che WhatsApp group, but I don't know if it's Facebook or whatever, but we have to need a common place where we electronically can be connected. So yeah, thank you all, and see you around.
Okay, so thank you all of you, and again, I cannot express more how thankful I am with all of the organizers that have been doing this very transformational experience, and we can see not only how much time you have spent in this, but also the effort and the passion, and the love in your work, and that is something that I admire from you. Yeah, the energy, the passion, that you put on in the work. So thank you very much for that. Thank you for the group. I've learned a lot from you. I felt very appreciated for all of you. So hopefully I can also, hopefully you felt appreciated for me too. If you didn't, you have a special place in my heart and in Ecuador too. So if you are in Ecuador, please call me. So in the professional level where I was before Puerto Plata, I was dealing with submitting manuscript for publication, dealing with rejection, dealing with the uncertainty of data. Those are the daily things that you do as a scientist, and also always you put in your paper, in your manuscript, how your data means for society and for change. And then I went to Puerto Plata, and Puerto Plata was a challenge.
for a scientist to think, you always think you make something for society, but you really end up doing because you don't have the whole picture. And you need to integrate the knowledge, and you need to learn how to synthesize and value other sources of knowledge. So for me, that was a transforming experience, a moving experience, to learn more how to build the network and the synergies that we need to make that kind of research, transdisciplinary research. So, also I talked with Gary, and Gary talked with us about his experience as an advisor. And I talked with him personally because I was hesitating to accept a position as an advisor. And then I talked with Marga. Marga brought to us the view of science and diplomacy. And for me, science and diplomacy were totally separated areas. And I was always hesitating to go into that world because as a scientist, you don't want to lose credibility when you interact with politicians and policymakers. So I was afraid of that. And talking with Marga, talking with Gary, and with many of you that are in the government, I will confidence and faith in the future. So I accepted the position as an advisor of science and outreach, with working with the vice president in my institution. And so from vision to action, so what are we value transdisciplinary research. We implemented a program about transdisciplinary research. We have in the country, our local agenda is called Plan para el Buen Vivir. And the goal of the Plan para el Buen Vivir is to make synergies to reduce poverty, to attack the main social problems in our country. So from that, I went to Washington to do the science diplomacy training, and I met Marga and Ernesto from UNESCO, and we discussed how can we bring the agenda into our daily actions in the university. And that's what I shared it with you, and thank you very much for all of you that have been talking with me about how can we implement this in the institution, in our daily activities, in our daily actions, how can we measure that, and why is it important. So all of this creative thinking, all of these new ideas, transforming actions, will not be possible if we didn't have the space, this space. Not only the beauty of the space, but also the spiritual connections, to learn from the experiences, uplifting experience from generations that have been transforming the pain to a victory and transformation in their own communities, no? And the passion that each of one has in their work. So that is what fosters here and a space for creative thinking and for transformation. And I thank you, all of you, so much for all of the input that you have bring into this space, and that has built in me the commitment to make a change in the place I am. So what comes next? I am just looking forward to learn more about your work, to learn more about what are you doing and how can I collaborate with you. And thank you very much again, and see you in any place in the world, see you in WhatsApp, or let's keep in touch. Thank you very much.
I want to start by saying, similar to Aaron, I only wish I'd been with you guys earlier, also in Puerto Plata, but I also want to thank IAI for creating, as Jessica was saying, this space to do this, because it is so unique to have this space, and I think it's so inspiring to be here and to spend this time with all of you, especially coming from the United States, where this is becoming more rare, and it's been a really depressing year, and this has been so inspiring to be here and to just reaffirm how important this like international sharing of all of your amazing expertise is. It's so humbling to come here and meet all of you. You're all so incredible. And so it's just been one of the best experiences I've probably had in like the last year to be here and to enjoy the diversity of everyone's knowledge and perspectives, and Gabby and Marcela and Mariana and everyone else whose tireless efforts went into making this possible, and especially for recognizing and making possible for us to meet Ramona and Dwayne and go to these sites and see the kind of diversity too of their perspectives. It's just been really, really special. And I'll just echo that 3.5 years ago, similar to some of you guys, I applied not knowing what I was getting into to come to one of these and met Gabby and Edwin and Marcela and Mariana and Marga and Kathy. And the last 3.5 years, this is like kind of touched everything that I do, this perspective and of interdisciplinarity, transdisciplinarity, and Gabby and I have now seen each other in like 6 or 7 countries, and yeah, and it's just these connections and relations, I think they only create new and even more interesting networks, and so yeah, it's really wonderful to kind of get to know all of you, but also see another kind of round of this happening and all of these connections and networks. So thank you for having me, and yeah, it was really wonderful to be here.
I have to hand it to you for being able to build such a community in 2 iterations over 2 5-day periods with a huge amount of variety, interjected with intellectual content, humor, drama, and you know, it was hard sometimes because like, oh God, I want to take a break. But the fact that we had fun and that Valentina would laugh or would sing for us, and last time we went dancing, we didn't go dancing this time, maybe tonight. But I guess it, you know, it was especially good for me to get away from thinking about transdisciplinary research as just this professional thing I do. What you've all reminded me of is that it is about long-term commitment to a place or people or resources that you deeply care about. It is about persistence. You know, being able to fail, like we learned a little bit about, that you're gonna try some things and it's not gonna work out. But the fact that you're persistent and you have relationships that last, that's okay. And I think what's persistent about being able to spend 10 days together is that there will be certain elements of this that will last for each of us, and it'll be different elements. But we will be applying those throughout the rest of our lives. And that's an amazing transformative thing. And I really do feel this was transformative, you know, in that it affects the head, the hands, and the heart, because we had to do things with our hands. We had to think really hard. We had to communicate all of that. But then, you know, like the last couple days, Ramona and Dwayne, what it really brought back to me was, I think everyone in this room really sees transdisciplinary research is about preserving human dignity within a sustainable planet. And what does that look like for us? And I just found it very moving to end the week with these people who have such long-term commitment and deep love of the land, and they're not gonna go away, and they're gonna remind us we need a just world in order to protect the planet. So it was a wonderful, wonderful end to the workshop.
About 4 years ago, Marcella and I started to write the proposal for this workshop. It took a lot of years and a lot of people's work. And I want to thank you, Marcella, for that opportunity, Gabby, for all the work that went into this week. It's an incredible honor and privilege to work with all of you. I think we all have this feeling of amazing, talented people coming from across two continents or one continent, we've been arguing about that. Together, it's easy to become pessimistic and negative in our beliefs about how we're going to solve global change problems, but being with all of you makes all of us optimistic that if we work together, we can solve some of them. So thank you very much for all your hard work over these past months. I know you don't want to say anything.
Well, everyone, I just want to say I'm extremely grateful to have met you, the ones I didn't know before. No, I'm extremely grateful to have met you all. And not only met you, but also share with you these 2 weeks, first in Puerto Plata and then here, and share our experiences and make sure that we were talking together and we were drinking together and we were dancing together and we were working together the whole time. Some of us have kept in touch. I hope we continue to be in touch. You have so much richness, and I will love to not only continue getting in touch and knowing about you and how you're doing, but also let's try to work together. Let's try to continue having this platform and see how can we, all of us can work. We're not going to do it at the same time, but there are connections we can make at different times. There are proposals that will come out that we can communicate to each other. There are conferences that we come out that we can communicate to each other. And lastly, I've been going to conferences and seminars for a long, long, long time. And I have only been in two conference of seminars where people, their participants, feel like a family. First one was PDCI, which is the Practitioners Dialogue for Climate Investments, which is the one that Jen talked about, and it was organized by GIZ, the cooperation agency from Germany. And the second one has been this one, these are the only two conference seminars where we were a family, we talked as a family, we continue relationships, we want to continue these relationships, but we work so hard and so much. So thank you.
Well, it was a pleasure to see you, all of you again, to meet you, Erin, to see Lily again. And I hope everybody enjoyed. Nice to meet you, Dom, too. I hope all of you enjoy. I worked to you to feel comfortable and have a good place. And don't worry about this kind of things. Let me worry about you. And I hope I can see all of you again and get in touch. Thank you very much.
So you mean at your wedding, right? We're all going to be.
I would like to end with a metaphor that I was thinking about. Let me see if I can tell you in English. According to yesterday, that we're in the sacred high place. It's common that in other cultures, obviously, the high place means something. And it's a Mapuche people related history. When they get these flat zones, they don't experience a high sacred place. So there is register of archaeologists that they see that when they has these flat zones, the elders of the communities in the flat zones bring soil from all the places and create like a almost pyramid. So to reach the sky and reach like objectives that are difficult to address. So for me, transdisciplinary process and the experience in this seminar is like this Mapuche ceremony where we create the network, the respect, moment, and I think this is necessary to create spaces to address common issues in a harsh world that all we see with our eyes, and sometimes it's difficult to get out of these problems and competitive things and common world things. So these structures, these almost pyramids, named Quel, in plural Queles, so Queles to the world, Queles para el mundo. Thank you.